Hummingbird Resources has told investors they've upped their stake in the under-construction Yanfolila gold project in Mali to 80% with the exercise of an option over a further 5% of the equity. Hummingbird's head of business development, Bert Munro, is with me on Skype now. Bert, good to see you. Good to speak.
Thanks for having me on the show.
Bert, tell me a bit more first off about what's involved here in this transaction.
Yeah, absolutely. So as you just stated, we had a previously agreed option agreement to acquire an additional 5% in the project. So the way it's currently structured is that the government of Mali owned 20% of the project and Hummingbird now owns the other 80%. There had historically been a 5% minority holder in the project who had been there since before we acquired the project from back in the goldfields days. So really it's just acquiring that 5% for the $1 million in shares, as you said.
And alongside this, you're also acquiring their 1% royalty. What's the benefit of acquiring the royalty to Hummingbird?
Well, the benefit's obviously greater revenue to Hummingbird. Currently, there's a 7.5-year mine life on the project. We firmly believe this mine life will extend well into the teens with further infill drilling and bringing our resources into reserve. So the value of the royalty is very large, and obviously, you know, that's the benefit of bringing it in. So currently, as it stands, the project now will only have a 3% royalty, which is all to the government of Mali.
Just before we turn to how things are coming along, just to re-emphasize what you mentioned before, you're not paying cash for this extra bit of equity. This is all being paid in shares, is it?
Yeah, exactly. It's all paid in shares. Those shares won't be issued until March of next year, but the price and the number of shares is locked in now. So exactly. So there'll be a long-term shareholder, and those shares will be issued in March.
Very good, Bert. So in terms of what's happening on the ground on site at the moment, how are things coming along? What's the latest?
Yeah, really well, actually. Thanks. Yeah, it's all going full steam ahead. So I guess recent news we've got out is the arrival of the ball mill on site, which is obviously a very big ticket item. Great to get it there slightly ahead of schedule and be ready to be put in place. Also, recently, we've had the arrival of a lot of the mining fleet. African Mining Services, who are our contract miner, have been mobilizing all of their kit to site. So, no, things are all going well. Thanks.
And you've recently signed a power contract. Is that right, in the last couple of weeks?
Yes, we signed up Zen Petroleum in the last couple of weeks. We also have signed up Aggreko as well, so to provide us with rented diesel power on site. So yeah, good to have them on board.
Absolutely, Aggreko is the one I was thinking about. Just remind us, when are you targeting first gold pour?
Yeah, first gold pour is targeted just before the year end. So currently in December. So yeah.
So an exciting 6 to 7 months ahead for you, Bert.
Yeah, exactly. A massive 6 months for us ahead. So everyone's looking forward to it. And full steam ahead, as I said.
What do you reckon is the, just before I let you go, what do you reckon is the next big sort of milestone for you? When are we likely to hear from you next?
I guess we're getting pretty close to the end of the quarter, aren't we? So I guess we'll certainly be having a Q2 update post the end of this quarter. So I suppose that'll be, you know, potentially be the next sort of material update. Between the end of Q1 and now, we haven't given a huge amount of updates on the progress on the ground. So I think that will obviously be a very full update. So I think that'll probably be the next major news flow.
Very good, Bert. Look forward to speaking to you then. Take care.
Great. Thanks very much. Thank you.